Hello again. We are on day two of restoring my Sea-Doo RXT. And I have decided to go ahead and use sandpaper. And the reason why is because without it, it looked pretty good. However, you can still faintly see the where the numbers were. And I didn't like that. Because I figure if I'm going to do it, I might as well do it all right. And you can still see a little bit here where that black was. So I'm going to go over that again. But I'm going to actually show you on this side the process of using the sandpaper. Because as you can see, the numbers are pretty pronounced because there's a lot of oxidation. So we want all of this to look like this. Oops, my fingers. This. So that's what it looked like. That's the original paint job before I got covered up with the numbers. So I'm going to start by using 400. I'm going to do it dry. And then I'm going to actually wet it and then do it again. And then I'm going to use the 1500 like I talked about on day one. I also bought a new restorer. It's actually Oxidation Restorer. I heard good about this brand, so we bought this as well. So we're going to use that too. So I'll be sanding it, dry sanding it, then wet sanding it, then using that with the buffer, and then using this with the buffer, and then it'll be ready for the numbers, because we plan on going out to play today. So as I had mentioned in my day one blog, I bought the Gator 400, and it is made for automotive paint, so it should be pretty safe on this. This is fiberglass, and I'm going to use this, but first, of course, you got to wipe it down with just your basic cloth, because you don't want to have any abrasives on here, like a twig fell or something, and you start sanding it with that underneath it, then you would actually scratch the finish. So just wipe it all down first. And again, you can see where all the stickers were, the decals. It's pretty pronounced. So we're gonna sand it down and get rid of that. And when you sand, make sure you do it in one direction. Because if you start doing it in swirls, you're actually going to make more problems for yourself, because then the swirls are gonna show up as scratches. You don't want that. So just do it one direction. And so, like this. And then you can wipe it down. Look at the progress as you go. Let's see. Alrighty, it's pretty well diminished. So I'm gonna do some more, and then I'll show you what it looks like when we're done. Alright, so I did the waxing first time, or first run. So now what I'm going to do is use the buffer and the other oxidation remover. So we will see how that works. Alright, when you go to use your buffer, put your solution on the pad like that, nice and, you know, all over the place. And then when you go to use it, you have to make sure that you actually rub it onto the surface first, because if you don't and you turn it on, you're gonna have stuff flying everywhere. Okay, so now this is after dry sanding it once and then using the oxidation remover with a polisher or buffer. I'm going to be doing it again because you can still see where the numbers were, but actually it's not very bad. But over here you can certainly see where they were. So I'm going to dry sand it again, and then I'm going to wet sand it. And so far for this section only, I've only used one sheet of 400 sandpaper. All right, so what we did here is we did dry sanding with a 400 grit. And then after I did that, I went ahead and polished it once with the oxidation remover. And then after that, I went ahead and dry sanded it again. And then wet sanded it both with a 400 grit. And did both sides, and my partner here is wiping it down for me.
Slaves are us.
She said, slaves are us. So now we're getting ready to, actually we're going to put the numbers on, because I think it looks like it's ready. Yeah, you can see very, very faintly where it was. So I mean, technically we could do it again, but honestly, you really can't see it. So, and look at that shine. It's probably not the original, but it's pretty dang close. So this bad boy is ready to call it quits when it comes to the front part of it. I'm also going to get some decals Which are actually in the mail in the process of getting here. We also ordered a new seat, so we'll move on to a little bit more. The back part was actually supposed to have red. This was supposed to be red, but then we thought about it and realized this is the red it would be. And that red probably won't match this rubber or the front. So we decided to just keep it black. And I'm also going to keep the other seat on that I already refinished. And I think we removed the original, didn't we? Or did we put this right over top of it?
Put it right over top.
Okay, so we're just going to keep piling it up so it's just more cushion. Better for jumping those waves. So that is day two. And I will show you what it looks like once we get the numbers on. Alright, so day two, we are completing with putting the numbers on, and here they are. We do need to do some work, of course, on the red here, and of course the red rubber here, so that they all look good. So we'll be doing that probably tomorrow. So what we did again was dry sanded it with a 400 grit, went through, then did the oxidation solution from Magellan's, on a buffer, then dry sanded it again, and then wet sanded it, and then again did the oxidation remover solution from Magellan's, whatever it's called, and then also did the restorer and wax. So as you can see, it did pretty good. You can't actually see any of the numbers that were there previously, so that's pretty good. Got all the oxidation off, or most of it, and it also has a nice shine to it. We also need to do a waxing to it, which we'll do on the top here, which will actually make it pop even more. But we're going to do that later on, because we still have quite a bit of work to do. So tomorrow, I plan on actually taking this whole thing apart tomorrow morning, or tomorrow night, or maybe even tonight. We'll see. And then painting some of it, trying really hard to clean up the rest of it, which that's all like plastic. And then the fiberglass, we still have a lot of work to do, of course, with that stupid decal glue there. And then cleaning up the mats again, because they got dirty from the fact that I don't have a cover on it yet. We bought a new one, waiting for that to come. And the seat, we have to do that too. So this is going to take a little bit of time yet. So actually from this point, I'm just going to do one more video when it's all done. I've already showed you everything we're going to be doing anyway. So now it's off to go play in the water.